friends, come read a story with us. I'm going to be reading my book, I Am Hunting for Happiness, by Hadia Schwarzman. Delilah woke up to a world that looked gloomy, lonely, and cold. Delilah was feeling sad. There are no friends to play with, it's too cold and windy, and I am not happy, she exclaimed to her frosty windows. But Delilah had a plan. I am going to hunt for happiness, she declared. I know it won't be easy, but I will capture it and make sure it never leaves my sight. First, I will find Will, the big bad troll. He must be hiding happiness in his cave, Delilah thought. So Delilah walked into the dark cave and was stopped by the big bad troll. Who dares to enter my fortress? He bellowed. It is me, Delilah, hunter of happiness. Please give me happiness, troll. I know you must be hiding it. Where is it? Delilah demanded. Happiness does not live here, he yelled. My latest invention has been destroyed. I am mad. Go hunt for happiness somewhere else, he yelled as he shut his door. That troll was not happy. He is not fun, but I must keep searching for happiness, Delilah said to herself. I know, Caroline, the fairy princess, must know where happiness is. Maybe she has a special potion for happiness hiding in her room, Delilah thought. The fairy was busy trying to find something to wear. Knock, knock. It is Delilah, hunter of happiness. Please give me a happiness potion, fairy princess. I know you must have it, Delilah pleaded to the fairy princess. Happiness does not live here, Delilah. I lost my favorite dress for the tea party and am very sad. Go hunt for happiness somewhere else, the fairy princess cried. Then she quickly ushered Delilah to the door. That fairy princess was too sad. That was not fun, but I know I must continue to find happiness, Delilah muttered. I know the queen must know where I can find happiness. She is the fairest and wisest of the land, so she must certainly know where happiness is hiding. Delilah peeked into the corner of the kitchen with her binoculars and spied on the queen. The queen looked frustrated. She was trying to plan a fancy ball, but the plates and silverware were not willing to participate. You expect me to do what?
Dish, let's get out of here.
Delilah pulled on the queen's dress to get her attention.
I'm feeling very frustrated. Did you come to help me, my dear? The queen pleaded.
No, but I can find help, Delilah replied. I'll find the king.
Delilah was excited to be placed on a special mission to help the queen. She raced through the hallway to grab her coat and made the long trek to find the ice king. Delilah carefully followed the footsteps in the snow to find him. She found him battling a mean monster. The king looked upset, but Delilah was determined to speak to him.
King, I need your help, Delilah begged.
I'm sorry, my dear. I am anxious. I must face this dreadful snow monster before he takes over our kingdom, the king replied.
But king, Delilah pleaded.
No buts, Delilah. I must handle this problem first.
Delilah walked back to her room, feeling defeated. Her hunt for happiness did not go as well as she had planned. In her room, she felt all alone. She did not know what to do with her sadness, so she began to cry. Will, Caroline, and Delilah's parents raced to her room.
Delilah, what's wrong? Delilah's father asked.
Did you fall or get a boo-boo?
No, it's worse than a boo-boo, Delilah cried. I searched everywhere in this house for happiness, and I couldn't find it.
happiness is gone," she said through her tears.
"I imagine that must feel awful, Delilah," her mother said.
"It is," Delilah replied through her tears. "I searched everywhere and I couldn't find it."
"I'm sorry, Delilah, but we can't help you find happiness, dear," her father shared.
"You can't?" Caroline said.
"But you're the parents. You're supposed to know how to fix everything. Now I think I'm sad," Will added.
"Yes, dear, your father's right. Happiness cannot be captured," Mom said. "We will all experience many emotions that make us feel mad, sad, frustrated, and anxious throughout our life. That's why you must remember you have something very special in your heart that helps you to create joy. It will help you during difficult times," her father said.
"I do?" Delilah asked.
"Yes, dear," her father said.
"Just close your eyes and you'll find it, honey," her mother said softly.
"I don't see it,"
Delilah whispered. "You have a great imagination, Delilah. Just close your eyes and picture what joy looks like," her father added.
"I didn't see it at first, but when I closed my eyes and imagined joy, it truly was there," Delilah realized. "Joy is something I create from the love in my heart."
"I have tons of joy," Delilah yelled in happiness.
"Great, let's share it," Will said excitedly.
"I found my joy from the love that lives in my heart. It was so big and beautiful that I had to release it and share it with the world," Delilah exclaimed.
My little one had so many ideas that he decided to use two pages. He wrote this poem that he wanted me to share. "Joy, oh joy, finding joy breezing through the wind. Where do I find you? In the blooming roses, in the river? How can I find you? Find me, find me, find me. Joy is within you. Make your joy. Joy is in the garden. Joy is with your friends. Joy is in the park. Joy is gazing at the stars. Slow down and live your life. Joy is everywhere."
And don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps other friends to find my content. Coming soon, I will be releasing my book, Little Duck. I hope you enjoy it. Bye, friends, and don't forget to create joy in your world.